If you're a beginner or an amateur artist and want to learn how to paint in easy steps, then you've come to the right place. Today is lesson number one, and I'm going to teach you how to paint these two wooden coasters in acrylic. Hi, my name is Jyotsna Nair, and welcome to Amateur Artist Forever. This channel has been created for beginners and amateurs. Lesson 1 is divided into two parts. In the first part, we will be painting this flower on the coaster, and in part 2, we will be painting the bird on the coaster. I'm using wooden coasters, but you can use cotton canvas instead. If you don't have cotton canvas, you can go for your sketchbook. I have my sketchbook here, which I have used to make some drawings of the same kind of flowers that I'm going to show in this tutorial. The thickness of this paper is 140 GSM. This is artist quality paper because we will be using acrylic paints which have water. A thinner paper will tear.
If you are using your sketchbook instead of a coaster, you can use any round medium size object to make circles with a pencil and then use your paint or sketch pens to make the pattern. If you are feeling anxious or stressed, I suggest you light a fragrant candle or play any soft music at low volume. Take 3 deep and slow breaths to calm your mind. We will need acrylic paints, paint brushes, a plate or a palette, water, and a rag. I'm using a sponge for painting the coaster. You can easily find these things at your local stationery store. You can use any of these colors in combination with titanium white. You can use Scarlet Lake or Medium Mauve, Cadmium Yellow, Lemon Yellow, Cobalt Teal, Cobalt Blue, Ultramarine Blue. And I also have a raw sienna on my palette. You can either use burnt sienna or raw sienna. Just make sure that you use very little of these colors with titanium white because we want a light background. First, I'm painting the background for the bird painting and I will keep it aside for drying. I am using cobalt teal and titanium white. Very simple, just mixing two colors. I'm using the sponge to mix very small amount of cobalt teal in titanium white. I want the background to be light and slightly tinted with color. Now continue to dab the sponge all around the coaster in a circular manner. If you don't have a sponge, I suggest you use a tissue paper. Just crumple it and roll it up into a ball. Use the ball to dab color on the coaster. If you are using color sketch pens or color pencils, you will skip this step. You will first draw a pattern and then fill colors. Because we haven't used water to mix the colors yet, the paint gives us enough time to cover the entire area before drying. With a couple of dabs, we have covered the coaster probably within a couple of minutes. Can you see the beautiful texture that you're getting? Just even out the colors, but only in a dabbing motion. Don't drag the sponge on the surface. And that's done. We will keep this aside while it dries and we will start on the next one. Now for the next one, I'm using cobalt teal, titanium white and a little bit of lemon yellow. And we follow the same process for this one as well. I have used more titanium white in this one because I wanted it lighter, and because I have mixed cobalt teal, which is essentially blue, and lemon yellow together, I have got a little greenish hue to the color. You can see my son sitting there right in front of me and working on his pattern in his sketchbook. This pattern is very simple and it is very easy to follow. My son is 6 years old and he managed to do it. I will share a picture of what he ended up doing at the end of this video. I would request you all to encourage your children by showing them this tutorial, and whatever tutorials I will be posting, I will have two levels in it. The easier level for kids to follow and a little bit technical, which adults can enjoy. And there you go, we have the second coaster ready for painting. We will let this dry first and then we will start with our flower. Now that our coasters are dry, let's go to the next step. I am using medium mauve, cobalt teal, lemon yellow, and silver gray to make my flower. You may use red, blue, and yellow. You can mix a little bit of titanium white in the primary colors and make them lighter. Whichever primary colors are easily available to you, you can use them. You can use titanium white and a little black to make gray. I'm mixing a few drops of water with mauve and I'm using a size 1 brush. I'm drawing petal shapes on the coaster. Do not worry about the sizes. Any mistake you do can be corrected later. Just keep your hand steady and draw one petal at a time. If your hand isn't steady, there is a simple solution. Make squiggly petals like this. Don't get bogged down by the shape of the flower or that your hand is not steady. This is your first class, and what is important is that you trying this out and doing it to the best of your ability. You can make markings for the petals, that way you have a rough guideline. Turn your coaster or sketchbook around as the paint is wet and we don't want to smudge our beautiful background. Now I'm using cobalt teal to fill the center. I'm making a heart in the center. You can make a star or any shape that you want. Later we are going to fill it with gray or white. I am using the same color to fill bottom half of the petal. For the top half, I will use mauve. We are trying to stay within the lines that we've drawn for the petal. This is the time to correct the shape of the petal. If you feel that a petal is fat or thin or a bit crooked, you can straighten it out now. If you see, I'm using very little water to mix with the cobalt teal. I'm just going to speed up the video for the last 2-3 petals. Now we will fill the tops of the petal with mauve. So far, we are keeping the colors simple and clean. We are not mixing any color with each other. This is the first layer of paint for the flower. It will look shabby, but don't worry. By the time we are done, it will be perfect. I keep correcting the shape of the petals to my liking as I go along with the painting. As the paint dries, you'll see some portion of the petals have lesser paint. Give it a touch of another layer of color so that the background is not visible. We have roughly done the first layer of petals. Time to fill the painting with more petals. Use mauve with few drops of water to make more petals in between the first layer. We will again use mauve to fill the top half of the petal. Now we will do some color mixing. The basic rule of color mixing is red, blue and yellow and white are primary colors, which means you cannot mix any color to get these colors. When you mix red with blue, you get purple. Yellow and blue make green and yellow and red make orange. Purple, green and orange are secondary colors. So now I will mix lemon yellow and mauve together to get a shade of orange. I will use this color for the bottom half of the petals. I am mixing mauve and cobalt teal together to make purple for the top part of the petals. I am not using pure blue and red, but since cobalt teal is essentially blue and medium mauve is a shade of red, my purples and oranges will be different from what you have on your brushes. Isn't that interesting? How with the same rule, we get different shades of secondary colors. So to recap, we learned what primary colors are and what secondary colors are. We learned to mix colors and apply them. I will only introduce one more concept right now, but we will discuss it in detail in future videos. Complementary colors or opposite colors. Complementary color for red is green, for yellow is purple, and for blue is orange. Complementary colors enhance each other when used besides each other, and if mixed together, they cancel each other out, and essentially you get a shade of gray. I am adjusting the shapes of my petals every chance I get. Don't aim for perfection in art. Sometimes imperfection is more beautiful. Don't forget to wash the brush every time you change the shade. You cannot see it, but I'm using a rag every time to wipe the brush. I don't want excess water in the paint. Now I'm filling the center with my silver gray. If you don't have gray, you mix a little bit of black in titanium white and use that color. If you want, you can use titanium white directly. We are nearly at the end of our painting. I'm just touching up on certain parts of the painting where I feel there is less color. You can be your own judge. You can leave it the way you feel. Now I'm going to finish my painting with a black outline. I'm taking a little bit of ivory black on the palette. I think an outline of black will enhance the flower. So take a few drops of water and mix it with ivory black. And when you are using the brush, try to have a pointed tip for the brush so that it will become easier for you to make the outline. Go as slow as you need. There is no need to rush this. It is very difficult for beginners to ensure that it's a thin line, but don't worry about it. Just go with the flow, and if you don't feel confident in doing the outline, just leave it. You can see that I'm also going about it very, very slowly, and I'm taking my time. And we are nearly done. I think this was the quickest way to paint. There is just no excuse not to paint. We finished the painting of the flower within 30 minutes. The bird painting is even simpler. We are going to use the same colors with addition of raw umber to the palette, and you will see a totally different painting emerge from the same colors. I want you all to share a pic of your work in the comments, or you can email me the pics on my email ID. I'm sharing the same below. I will collate every week the paintings shared by you guys and share them on this channel with your names. I think this will motivate the kids as well as the adults to do a good job and follow instructions and bring out your creativity. Take it as a homework. I will make a time-lapse video of all the paintings that you guys share, and I will release it in between two lessons. I think this is a great idea, and I think you all will love it.
We have come to the end of this lesson and this video. I want you to do your homework and post it in the comments below so that I can see them. And if you have any feedback for me, please do share it so that I can incorporate the changes in the future videos. Please do hit the like button for me. Make sure you click on the subscribe button so that you are informed about the next lesson that I will be posting on this channel. If you feel this video can help someone, please feel free to share the link with them. Till then, keep practicing, stay positive, and be proud of what you've created today. See you soon. Bye-bye.